sigma instruments. In today's class, we will be continuing and learning about the types of reactions, which is displacement reaction. This is the third type of reaction. Earlier we learned about combination and the types of decomposition reactions. So, in order to understand displacement reaction, first let us learn about what is meant by reactivity series. Now, reactivity series is a series of metals arranged in a decreasing order of their reactivity. What is this meant by decreasing order of their reactivity? When you try to arrange from the most reactive metal to the least reactive metal, what we get is the reactivity series. Now, in the reactivity series, there are three parts, part 1, part 2, and part 3. Now, what is part 1? In part 1, we have metals which are above hydrogen in the reactivity series. What does it mean? It means that all these metals are more reactive than hydrogen. In part 2, we have hydrogen. Now, why is hydrogen placed in the reactivity series of metals? Hydrogen, like all these metals, can lose its electron. Because of this character, hydrogen is placed in the reactivity series of metals. Now, below hydrogen, we have certain amount of metals like copper, mercury, silver, gold, and platinum. Now, why these are placed below hydrogen? Because they are less reactive than hydrogen. So, overall, what we can say is this. In the reactivity series of metals, we have more reactive metals, we have hydrogen, and we have less reactive metals. The metals which are more reactive than hydrogen can remove hydrogen from its solution, and the ones which are below hydrogen cannot displace hydrogen from its solution. So, why we should learn all this? In order to understand what is meant by displacement reaction. So, hope this is clear for you. So, what is the most reactive element? Potassium. Who is less reactive than potassium? Sodium. Barium. Now, calcium is less reactive than sodium, potassium and barium, but it is more reactive than any of these elements. That means, if I consider magnesium, the elements which are above magnesium are more reactive than magnesium, and the ones which are below magnesium are less reactive. Similarly, if I consider iron, the elements which are above iron can displace iron from its solution, and the elements which are below iron cannot displace iron from its solution. Now, coming to the definition of displacement reaction. A reaction in which a more reactive element displaces means that removes a less reactive element from its compound are called displacement reactions. I repeat the definition again. A reaction in which a more reactive element displaces a less reactive element from its compound are called displacement reactions. Now, to understand displacement reactions, let us consider two examples. Okay? In example 1, we are asked to take some amount of copper sulfate solution in a test tube. We are asked to observe its color. So, if I take copper sulfate solution, it is generally blue in color. Okay? Then, I am supposed to add some shining iron nails to it. Now, I have two iron nails. What I am trying to do is, I am trying to add an iron nail to it. Observe what happens after some time. So, I am keeping it separate after certain amount of time. Now, let us take example 2. Take some copper sulfate solution again in a test tube. Add a piece of zinc metal granules to it. Observe what happens after some time. So, here again I am trying to take some amount of copper sulfate solution to which I will be adding some amount of zinc granules. Now you can see the zinc metal granules. These zinc metal granules have been added to the copper sulfate solution. I am keeping it aside for the observation. Now let us try to understand the displacement reaction in a very clear way. Before that, I will try to explain these particular reactions in a detailed way. What happens here? Now listen carefully. Now what did you do? You added iron to copper sulfate solution. Let us see, where is iron? It is somewhere here in the reactivity series. Where is copper? Copper is placed here in the reactivity. So, who is more reactive? Iron is more reactive than copper. So, what happens here? The more reactive iron displaces less reactive copper to form FeSO4 plus Cu. What are the observations? And when we write the observations here, number 1, the blue color of copper sulfate changes to green. Why did it change to green? Because of the formation of ferrosulfate. Next, red brown color copper gets deposited on the iron nail. Now, why did it happen? Let me explain. Now, when iron is added to copper, iron loses its two electrons and forms into Fe2 plus ions. When iron is added to copper sulfate solution, iron will lose two electrons and forms Fe2 plus. Whereas, copper, in the copper sulfate solution, accepts these electrons to form copper. Now, this is reddish brown in color, which gets deposited on the iron. So, what we get is, the more reactive element called iron will take the place of copper in the copper sulfate solution to form FeSO4. So, more reactive iron displaces copper from its solution to form ferrosulfate, and the copper gets deposited on the iron. Let us see the observation. Now, this is the iron nail that I have taken. You can see very clearly that a reddish brown color iron nail has been formed. Now, this is because of the formation of what? Because of the formation of copper on the iron nail. So, you can see the reddish brown color of the iron nail. Now, this solution changes to pale green. Why? Because of the formation of ferrosulfate. Now, let us see the other example also. Now, if we consider the second example, that is Zn plus QSO4 gives what? Now, if you move towards the reactive series, you can see that zinc is placed above copper. So, what can you expect? Obviously, that zinc sulfate is formed and the copper gets deposited on the zinc reactants. What does it mean? It means, number one, zinc will displace copper from where? From the copper sulfate solution. And the second one is, solution becomes colorless, then copper gets deposited on the zinc granule. Now, these are the observations. And this is the balance of chemical equation for this particular reaction. Let us see what happens. Now, if we consider the zinc kept in copper sulfate solution, now you can see very clearly that the zinc granule has changed it to reddish brown color. After some time, this solution also will lose its color. So, this is a typical example of a displacement reaction that is taking place. Now, let us run some more examples. Now, let us see some more examples of displacement reaction. So, here, first we are trying to learn about the reaction of zinc with HCl and H2SO4. HCl is a hydrochloric acid, H2SO4 is sulfuric acid. Now, before I go this, I should locate where is zinc. Now, zinc is very clearly above hydrogen in the reactive acids. It means that zinc can displace hydrogen. So, what do we expect to form? We will be getting zinc chloride, which is aqueous solution, and hydrogen gas is eventually evolved. In the same way, zinc displaces hydrogen from sulfuric acid to form aqueous solution of zinc sulfate along with the formation of hydrogen gas. Let us see the fourth example. What happens if copper is placed in zinc sulfate solution? So, here you have a metal called copper placed in zinc sulfate solution. Now, we need to check the reactivity series again. Where is copper? Copper is below hydrogen. Where is zinc? Zinc is more reactive than copper. So, zinc cannot displace copper. So, what can we write here? There is going to be no reaction which is going to take place. Now, hydride is a as copper is less reactive than zinc, copper cannot displace zinc, so there will not be any particular reaction. Now observe the fifth example. Copper kept in silver nitrate solution. Now what is copper is above silver in the reactivity series. That means copper is more reactive than silver, so it can displace silver to form copper nitrate solution, which is aqueous, along with silver getting deposited on the copper. So the copper will get a white color shining surface. Now coming to silver placed in copper sulfate. As silver is less reactive than copper, there will not be any particular reaction here. There is no reaction in this particular series. What happens if copper is placed in water? Now we know that hydrogen is above copper, so copper cannot displace hydrogen. So there will not be any particular reaction here as well. Now coming to magnesium placed in copper sulfate. Again, if you see the reactivity series, magnesium is more reactive compared to copper. So obviously what will happen, a displacement reaction happens. So MgSO4, an aqueous solution of MgSO4 plus Cu is formed. In the same way, lead is more reactive than copper. So you will be getting lead chloride, which is aqueous, along with the formation of copper. Coming to sodium's reaction in water. Now you can see very clearly that sodium is more reactive than copper. So when sodium is placed in water, sodium being more reactive than hydrogen displaces hydrogen from water to form NaOH plus H2. So hydrogen gas is released in this particular reaction. When we try to balance, it will be 2 NaOH plus H2 plus a lot of heat energy is also involved. Generally, displacement reactions are exothermic in nature. Now coming to this one, Al plus Fe2O3. Now this is a very important reaction, which is also called a thermite reaction. Aluminium is above iron in the reactivity series, so aluminium displaces iron to form aluminium oxide Al2O3, which is the liquid. So here iron is obtained in liquid form. The most important thing to be noted here is iron is obtained in molten form. Now this particular iron which is available is used for welding railway tracks together and for joining bracket machine parts. So these are the various examples of displacement reaction. So to decide whether a particular reaction takes place or not, you should have a thorough knowledge about the reactivity series. Now coming to the reactivity series of non-metals. Just like metals, even non-metals can be grouped into reactive and non-reactive in nature. For example, fluorine non-metal is the most reactive, and iodine, which is a solid, is the least reactive of the non-metals. So here fluorine can displace chlorine, bromine and iodine. Chlorine can displace bromine and iodine. Bromine can displace iodine, and iodine is the least reactive. For example, when chlorine gas is passing through potassium bromide, here more reactive chlorine displaces bromine from potassium bromide to form potassium chloride, and bromine gas is given up. So the solution turns light brown in color due to the dissolution of bromine gas. This is one example of the reactivity series of non-metals. In example 2, chlorine gas when passing through potassium iodide, chlorine being more reactive non-metal, displaces iodine from its solution to form potassium chloride, and iodine, which is a solid, gets dissolved into the solution and gives a violet color to the solution. So this violet color is because of the formation of iodine. So this is about the reactivity series of non-metals. So displacement reactions can be better explained by using reactivity series. Hope you understood. But the most important thing about displacement reaction is that they are always exothermic in nature. So we can consider almost every displacement reaction as exothermic reaction. And because a single element displaces another element from its solution, we call it as single displacement reaction. So in our next video, we will be discussing about double displacement reaction. Thank you.